Hi, Kathleen. Yeah, there's a new city ordinance in place at the beginning of the month. Basically, it states that whenever there's a big event in town, like Comic-Con that was down here this past weekend, things like this, the rideshare scooters and the bikes, can't be too close. Basically, just too much foot traffic gets in the way. It makes for a mess. But the debate is, should the city be allowed to confiscate this, and should the companies have to pay now to get them back? It seems as though every bird in the city has migrated to this lot. Limes, lifts, and jump logos seen here too.
As you can see, it makes for quite a view.
All these scooters taken off the streets between just last Thursday and Sunday.
We had a geofenced area where we weren't allowing scooters or bikes to be left by either companies or their users.
Here's what the area looked like all mapped out. The red area, the property the convention center sits on. The yellow, the surrounding blocks of the gas lamp district.
If the users are using them in here, it'll, the max speed is 3 miles per hour.
And so if, like, let's say,
but they can't leave them in here either. They have to be left outside of that.
The city confiscating 2,500 scooters, and they fined the companies $65 for each one. The city tells us one company's already picked up their scooters, about 600 units, $40,000 worth. But look what's left. Yeah. We're talking serious money, about $200,000 worth.
We don't want to make a profit. We're just trying to recover the cost.
So far, the city says Lime and Jump have been willing to pay to get theirs back. But Bird has given them the silent treatment. The streets around the gas lamp district a little less cluttered Monday as a result.
It sucks that the company is being faulted for consumers using.
Scooter rider Janet Fennell says scooter companies need to warn riders to stay away from restricted areas. But her friend Eric says it wouldn't change his plans.
Probably just run the risk a little bit here and there. You know?
Yeah, it's not your $65, right?
It's really not.
Yeah, and in an email to Fox 5 here this afternoon, Bird says that the city violated the permits out here. They didn't have the right to confiscate these in the first place. They haven't agreed to pay the fine to get them back. The city says, well, if they don't pay, I guess we're going to hold on to these, and we're not sure exactly what we'll do with them next. Maybe a big garage sale. We'll keep you up to date here on Fox 5. From the Gaslamp District, Jeff McAdam, Fox 5 News.
Jeff, thank you.